The story starts with a red-haired woman riding a motorcycle and carrying a baby and in a sheet tied to her torso. She's being followed by someone in an old vintage car. She creates a distraction using a lock of her hair to perform magic and leaves the car way behind her. She takes a baby to an orphanage and puts a letter in the cloth. The baby is wrapped in and leaves her at the front door of the orphanage. The name of the orphanage is St. Morwell's Home for Children. The matron of the orphanage comes out after hearing Earwig, the baby, cry, and reads the letter that was in her wrapping cloth. The letter says, 12 witches are looking for me. It might take years for me to shake them off. I'll be back for this baby. Until then, take care of her. The matron of the orphanage changed Earwig's name to Erica Wigg. The little Earwig grows up and is a quite mischievous child. She dresses up as a ghost with the other children and scares the people who walk past the orphanage. Erica goes up to the roof with her friend Custard, knowing that the matron will yell at them for doing so. Custard was afraid, but Erica tells him to come anyway. Custard asks Erica while they are on the roof that she ever wanted a family of her own. Erica says no. No one would want me in their family. It'll be boring to live in a normal family. I'd rather live in the orphanage. The next day, someone comes to the orphanage to adopt a child. Erica doesn't want to be adopted, so she makes her face look ugly by making weird expressions. But her bad luck, even after trying so hard, she gets chosen by the woman who comes to the orphanage. Erica refuses to go with the woman, but the matron tells her, "It'll be alright. You'll live the same neighborhood. You can always come here to meet your friends." Still, Erica is angry that for the first time in her life, she's being made to do something she doesn't want to. At last, she goes with the woman to her house. The house is number 13. Seeing this, Erica says perfect for the woman. She tells Erica that her name is Bella Yaga, and she's a witch, and she needed a hand with sorcery. Then, Erica makes a deal with Bella Yaga that if she agrees to teach her magic, she'll help her out with what she wants. She agrees to it. Bella Yaga gives Erica an apron and takes her into the shop where she keeps ingredients for magic. She warns Erica not to disturb Mandrake, the man who lives in the house with them. A cat also lives in this house. The name of the cat is Thomas. It is Bella Yaga's familiar. While Bella Yaga is on the phone with someone, Erica reads her grimoire out of curiosity and finds a spell in it useless. Bella Yaga hands up the call and uses her magic to make a dog named Poppy with the dog competition. Win the dog competition. That night, Erica secretly sneaks into the room. The room is a huge library filled with a lot of books. There are some creatures in the library that make Erica get out of there. Erica goes into another room. In this room, she finds the car that chased her when she was a baby. The name Earwig was written on the car. She comes out of that room too. She notices that the doors in this house are disappearing and reappearing according to their needs. She goes to her room to sleep. The next morning, Bella Yaga wakes her up and yells at her for being lazy. After this, Erica gets ready and goes into the kitchen to learn how to make breakfast. Bella Yaga sends her to get some ingredients from the garden. Then, Erica tries to escape slowly, but the plants there catch her and doesn't let her go. Those are the demons put up by Mandrake every way out. Then, Erica thinks to herself that she must make Mandrake do whatever she wants. Only then can she escape this godforsaken place. Erica asks Bella to teach her magic. She tells her to go pick some more ingredients from the garden. She just uses her to do chores but doesn't teach her magic. She makes her wash all the utensils. Erica goes back to bed. She finds a radio and plays a cassette in it, and in that cassette has songs composed by the band named Earwig. She listens to the songs and talks to Thomas the cat. She starts calling Thomas Custard, the name of her friend from the orphanage, and goes to sleep. The next day, Erica is put through the same work as yesterday. She goes back to bed when it's dark. This time, the cat Thomas talks to Erica and tells her that it would guide her through the house and help her read the grimoire to use a spell that can protect both of them from magic. After reading the book, Erica says we need hundreds of ingredients to finish this spell. To that, Thomas says we have all night to make it work. Both of them start working on the spell and finally make the spell work and go back to sleep. The next morning, Bella wakes Erica up and yells at her to make breakfast for the mandrake. To that, Erica replies, "Make one of her mandrakes do that for him. I wouldn't do it." She tells Bella that she is not a slave. Mandrake, who is in the next room, hears all this and gets irritated. After all of this, Bella makes Erica go out in the rain to the garden to get new ingredients. Erica gets back the ingredients, but Bella doesn't like them and yells at Erica. Then Erica says, "I'm not your slave. I won't do whatever you want of me." Erica says to Bella, "You promised to teach me magic, but you're only making me get ingredients. I want you to learn magic now." To this, Bella replies, "No, I won't teach you magic," and hits her on the head. After this, Erica eats lunch and starts to work again. She cleans the house, utensils, and walls. After a while, Bella leaves the house. Erica uses a spell to give a person an extra pair of hands on Bella with Thomas's help, but she needs Bella's hair to make the spell work. So after Bella comes back, Erica starts to link around Bella to get her hair. While doing this, she looks into Mendrick's room through a hole, and she sees him playing the piano. After this, she again looks for Bella's hair, but she was not successful in getting her hair. The next day, Erica searches again for Bella Yaga's hair. This time, she looks in one of Bella's hat, and she finds a lock of hair in the hat. The spell goes wrong, and a lot of worms come out of a portal into the house. These worms make the Mandrake very, very angry. Erica traps Bella Yaga and goes into the Mandrake's room and sees a poster of the band Earwig, in which Bella Yaga was the drummer, Mandrake was the guitarist, and a redhead woman who left Erica in the orphanage was the lead singer. In the past, all of them were good friends. Their band breaks up because a redhead lady who left Erica at the orphanage broke the witch's laws. She says that a set of laws can't stop her from living the life she wants. In the present, the house is all messed up, and now the Mandrake's anger is gone. Mandrake tells Erica that she can learn magic. Erica goes to Bella and tells her she was told that she's going to learn magic, and hugs Bella and tells her she wants to be like her. Now Bella has a soft spot for Erica and tells Erica to clean the mess she created, but not in a bossy way. Mandrake gives Erica his manuscript to read, and Erica praises Mandrake about his writing. She says his writing is pretty good, and she wants to read more of what he writes. Mandrake says he'll be writing more, and sends her the copies to read. In the climax, it's Christmas Eve. Custard and the redhead lady come to the house number 13. Erica, for Christmas, opens the door for both of them and looks at the redheaded lady, and is shocked to see her. Then the redhead lady says Merry Christmas, Earwig, and the story ends here.